So a very warm welcome to one and all, and welcome to the instruction course on periocular aesthetics, case-based skill transfer learning. In normal circumstances, we would have had live sessions, but we would try to compensate for it as best as possible through our talks. So, just an introduction, the instructors for this would be myself, Dr. Kasturi, who needs no introduction, and a young budding, colleague of ours, Dr. Vatsalya, who would be covering certain topics. There is an overview to the course where I would be covering on a new concept called the aging trigger points. Vatsalya would be covering on the consultation decoded. And then me and Dr. Kasturi will be taking you over the non-surgical and surgical periocular rejuvenation techniques. These are some of my disclosures. I'm a consultant with AMI, India and Asia Pacific, that is Allergan, and also on board for complications for fillers. And just a brief about myself that I'm a vegan, interior designer by passion, and obviously I love being fit and beautiful, and that's why I think I love the aesthetic industry. Some background of my alma maters and how my journey has unfolded over the years. I'm a fellow from Shankar Netralaya, then from University of Wisconsin, and then I was fortunate enough to found two companies, which is Foresight Private Limited, which does the super specialty work in Africa and overseas, and also my own brand called Clinica Phi, and you can visit the website to know me better. So to begin with, I'm just going to mention that, which is known to us, is that, aging is a fact of life. We all are going to age sooner or later. But looking your age is absolutely not. It is our choice. So it depends on us how we want to be perceived in this world, as far as the aging is concerned. And most of you may have seen this picture of mine, but just to reiterate on the fact that, aging starts age of as early as 10 years, where you can look at the features in the periocular, perioral area, especially, and see yourself. So you are the best judge to see how you have been aging over the time. And it's like assessing yourself over a period of time to see the aging factors. And the concept of the oval face changing into square and the gravitational forces working more to cause the aging. And I'll be covering that a little later. Of course, it's just for the interest of the beginners who have entered the aesthetic industry that whenever we are dealing with any procedure, we always divide the face into zones or in areas. And the simplest ways to call it as upper, mid, and lower face, and their specific demarcations. And based on the areas, anatomical areas which it covers, there are different types of treatment modalities which are available. Now, let's focus on the key topic, which is the aging trigger points. Now, see, most of the times what happens is when the patient walks into the clinic and asks you for a treatment, we start targeting on a specific. For example, a patient would walk in and say, I have got forehead wrinkles, please treat it. But the concept is changing to the more holistic approach, and the consultation with Vatsalya would cover is more targeted towards the emotional factor and the good feel factor, the feel good factor. And the basic points which we need to include in when we are talking to our patients is actually, how old are you? It's not a bad thing to ask, because your chronological age, your skin age, and your tissue age is important to understand and differentiate between that. And how old does the patient or the client feels him or herself that he is looking? And looking and feeling. So there are two different aspects of it. And also, when did they feel they looked their best? So most of us now feel that 40s and 50s are new 20s, because we are in best of our shapes. So it all depends from the ethnicity and the cultural background. I think this is of paramount importance to understand before we undertake any kind of treatments. Obviously, health markers are very, very important to concentrate before we venture into any kind of treatment, because they not only affect the way the aging is happening, but also the outcome and the longevity of our treatments. obviously intrinsic and extrinsic factors, as I mentioned, which includes your genetics, your DNA, and the kind of lifestyle one has been leading. A word upon the facial, sorry for the spelling mistake there, the facial aesthetic units, that it has been divided into initially 7 units and then modified into 12 units, which starts from the frontal, supraorbital, orbital, infraorbital, and so on and so forth. Based on these facial aesthetic units is where the actual aging trigger points are talked about. And when we look at these aging aid units specifically, what we look out for is the aging signs, which is nothing but lines, fold, and skin quality in the gradation of 0 to 4. So when we look about aging trigger points, we look from up to down, that is from forehead to chin, and laterally from your lateral to the medial side. And we look at the soft tissue aging trigger points and the bony trigger points. That means the soft tissue and the skeletal network, which we know about. So let's look at another format of that. Is that whenever, so this, when I was making, I just took random pictures and videos of mine. So these are not very professional looking, but I didn't want it to look very professional. Is that when we look up, which is against the gravity, everything falls back and, you know, the signs of aging actually reverses, versus when we look down is where the gravitational force will work and we would start to look more aged. So if in a static position, in a dynamic position, and also in a looking down position, the signs of aging are more evident. That means that's the severe aging, or it's a beginning of severe aging, which needs immediate treatment and would help the patient. So let's look at one of my videos where I just took it, where I'm animating. Now my forehead and periocular area is Botoxed, so you'll not see much happening there. And I'm trying to animate as much as possible to see which muscles, which tissue, which zone, which facial aesthetic unit is looking more aged. And as I look up and down, you can see the aging is more prominent. So if I look up, I'm actually grade 0 to 1, but when I look down, it's actually grade 2 to 3. And Rashman was kind enough, my better half, to give me this video. And I forced him to, you know, have this video again, is that when you look up again, you see how his face looks more skeletonized and there is no sign of aging. But when he looks down, you can see the periorbital aging, the mallard cheek area, the nasolabial folds getting more prominent. And of course, on animation, there are a lot of signs of aging in terms of the rachitis, folds, and the skin laxity. So what are these trigger points? They are divided into 16 points based on the facial aesthetic units. And we look at them in the 20s, 30s, and late 40s, 50s, which depends on the age of presentation of the patient. So at any age of point, if these points are severe in degree, that is the soft tissue and the bone tissue, one, it needs immediate treatment. And second, if we don't deal with them, then the severity of aging is going to be more and the treatment hence becomes more and more complex and difficult. So as we all know, the sooner we start, the better we can hold on to the aging process. I'm not going to go into the details because it's too much into detail and we can have a separate talk, or if anybody's interested, we can have separate sessions for it later. And as I mentioned, we have to look into the tight, saggy, angry, sad, the emotional quotient of it. And this has been invented and promoted by Dr. Mauricio Di Maio, who is, according to me, an artist and who has got into all these concepts of looking at the facial aging and the treatment of facial aging in a totally different concept. So based on the aging, we can divide it into the green, yellow, and red zones. And if it's green, based on the points and the degree, that means you can monitor. And if it is in, you know, there is a grading scale and a nomogram. If it is yellow, most of the points are yellow, then you have to consider the treatment. And if it's red, of course, you need to treat it immediately. How does these points actually help? So these points actually help by early diagnosis and detection of the aging process or the changes which is happening. Early treatment, which is of paramount importance. Delay aging. Now, when I say delay aging, doesn't mean that your natural aging is going to stop. But what it is going to do is it's going to hold on to the skeletal network, the ligaments, the fat in a proper way, because we know that all the surgical and non-surgical treatments do delay the process of aging. And of course, over a period of time, it's going to decrease the severity. So this is a very new concept which we are applying to both our surgical and non-surgical patients. And there's a long way to go into this. But yes, it has been introduced in the Western world and people are following, especially in the injectable area. So this is about the aging trigger points. And last but not the least, consultation is of paramount importance. As I mentioned that looking at a wrinkle is not important. Looking at the face in total is important. Looking at a condition is not important. It is important to understand the lifestyle and the background from where the patient or the client is walking in, because you know all these factors at the end combine together and affect the way one is aging, not only on the face but as well as on the whole, which is concerned. So I would just stop here, and I would introduce Vatsala to take it over from here to talk about the consultation being decoded, because I think that's very, very important when we are talking to patients about the procedures and counseling them to get converted and also making them happy over the period of time with our treatment modalities.